The machines of flight. Each began as an idea, a dream, a picture in the mind. For the picture to become real, ideas must take shape as concepts, which can be tested and verified. This is Langley, where dreams become reality. Once an historic plantation, and now NASA's Langley Research Center, this is where engineers solve the problems of flight, where lessons of the past provide solutions for the future, where pictures in the mind become the aircraft and spacecraft of tomorrow. They were dreamers, too. In December 1903, Orville and Wilbur Wright were building a machine in the hopes it would fly. It did, at a speed of just over 7 miles an hour. At first, the world took little notice. The Wrights were persistent. They demonstrated that their flyer had command of the air. European military planners paid attention. As the governments of Europe invested heavily in aeronautical research, they wrested technical leadership in aviation away from the United States. On the eve of the Great War, Europe's combatants counted thousands of military aircraft. The U.S. had 23. Armed combat quickened the pulse of technology. In 1914, trouble in the Balkans flared into the bloodbath of World War I. Flying machines were produced in great number, although these early airplanes were dangerous to fly. The war spurred America to action. In 1915, Congress created the National Advisory Committee for Aeronautics.
What World War I did was take aviation out of the hands of the tinkerers and the sportsmen and really created an industry for the first time, created an infrastructure for American aviation. And the National Advisory Committee for Aeronautics, or the NACA, proved to be a vital cog in that infrastructure.